Greetings LT gamers, welcome back to the channel. My name is Tom and today we're delving into the exciting realm of city building games. 2024 is proving to be a bumper year for the genre, and there is a wave of eagerly anticipated releases coming up on the horizon. From meticulously crafted historical settings to whimsical fantastical scenarios, there is a real wealth of diverse experiences coming up. In this video, we're going to jump into an exploration of the top 12 upcoming city builder games that are igniting fervent anticipation within the gaming community. And then quite a few that I also feel are being slept on and could use a bit more attention. Now you might be wondering how we have curated this extremely illustrious list. Well, it wasn't merely a surface level selection. We assessed each title considering a multitude of factors, such as gameplay mechanics, visual fidelity, developer pedigree, and what is the form of the release going to be, early access or so on. We've also taken into account the buzz and excitement surrounding each of these forthcoming titles within the gaming community, or maybe lack thereof. Are they capturing the collective imagination? And we're here to shed light on what is making those titles so compelling. So without further ado, LT gamers, let's delve in to the essence of some urban innovation. Alrighty, LT gamers, let's talk about our first title, Nova Roma, the city-building game that's like having the glory of Rome right at your fingertips. Picture this, you're not just constructing buildings, you're also juggling the whims of gods, passing laws, and making sure your citizens are happy and content. Now, why is this one intriguing to me? First of all, it's Hooded Horse. So if you've been keeping an eye on the gaming scene lately, you know that Hooded Horse has been hitting it out the park with city builders like Against the Storm. And I think Nova Roma is going to be no exception when it comes to this. These guys know how to deliver. It's also a history buff's dream. If you're like me and cannot get enough of historical city builders, then Nova Roma is right up your alley. It's got all the vibes from me of classics like Caesar and Pharaoh, which I grew up on. And with that sweet, sweet supply chain management and a dash of god appeasement thrown in, it's gonna be an absolute blast, I think. And then I think from a visual point of view, Nova Roma is boasting a really colorful art style, and it's making you feel like you've stepped into that painting of ancient Rome, majestic temples, bustling marketplaces, all vividly brought to life. So if you want to channel your inner emperor and build the ultimate Roman city, then I think Nova Roma is one to definitely keep an eye on. Alright fellow history buffs, gather around, we're jumping into our next one, which is Builders of Egypt. Now if you're anything like me and have a soft spot for historical city builders, especially classics like Pharaoh, then this could be one to keep an eye on. It's intriguing for a number of reasons, but first and foremost it has echoes of the classics. You're diving back into ancient Egypt, you're building your city up, you're managing your resources, and you're constructing monuments. So it's going to seek to capture the essence of the classic city builder Pharaoh, while still building upon it in the modern era. Political intrigue, diplomacy, expeditions, there's a lot of cool features thrown in for good measure, but the main thing I'm excited about is the stunning visuals. They look jaw-dropping to me, crisp, detailed, it feels like I'm being transported back onto the banks of the Nile. However, I think there is a major red flag on this one, and that is the title that preceded this one, Builders of Greece. I've seen a huge amount of complaints about bugs, lack of polish in the product. Now it is early access, but it's still not at a level that it probably should have been released. I really hope Builders of Egypt can learn from this. It seems like it's coming out in early access as well, but I hope the devs have learned from their past mistakes and ensure a smoother experience this time around before they tarnish their reputation too far and this franchise is a write-off. In our next title, you're not just any old leader, you're an orc warchief, and you're leading your tribe in a battle for survival against those pesky humans. This is Orc Warchief Strategy City Builder. And it's a game where you rebuild your village, train your warriors, and gear up for the fight of your life. It has a number of intriguing elements, but first of all, who doesn't want to play as an orc warchief? You're not just another hero, you're rallying your people against the forces of humanity. And this is a real fresh take for me, and it has me itching to raise that war banner and gather the horde. Of course, resource management is going to be a part of this. It's not just going to be bashing skulls. it's going to be balancing expansion with the needs of your clan. Each member will have unique skills that you can bring to the table, and of course you're going to have to make those tough decisions to keep your clan thriving. And speaking of fighting, there is also going to be epic battles and tactical warfare. So it's about proving your mettle on the battlefield as well as in the city building elements. So if you're ready to lead your tribe to victory in a world where might makes right, then Orc Warchief Strategy City Builder might be the game for you. For the next one, we're heading up to the mountains with Laysara Summit Kingdom. So roll up your sleeves and build your very own settlements high up in the clouds. With this one, you're not just building any old town, you're building in the mountains, and it's not going to be all sunshine and rainbows. You're going to have to carefully plan production chains, dodge weather breakdowns, and watch out for pesky avalanches. More than that, you're going to have to satisfy the various needs of your three caste society, from workers to the elites. So finding the balance and making sure your town is the place to be. And then there are elements of a persistent world also promised. So past towns that you've made will add into this tapestry within the game. It seems like a very engaging one for me, but it's kind of fallen under the radar. So I'm glad to bring it onto the channel and one I'll keep tabs on in the future. For our next one, we're going to talk about the Bustling World. And this is an open world RPG that's going to have a lot of city building elements thrown in for good measure, so I thought it'd be a worthy inclusion in this list. So it's not going to be a run of your mill city builder. You're going to focus on survival, cultivation, management, crafting, building, and exploration all rolled into one. The primary goal is going to be to cultivate your farm, however, so there's going to be 60 varieties of plants, and each going to have its own quirks, so soil type, water, temperature are all going to play a role in you running your own botanical paradise. But there are going to be a huge amount of city building elements, so there's a sophisticated construction system that have nearly 2,000 components, over 1,000 items and artifacts to play around with, so the possibilities here are going to be huge. I think you should think of this more as playing like a SimCity, but with a lot more control of your character. So if this one tickles your fancy, it's a little bit different, but I've thrown it in here for good measure. Switching gears now from single player over to the multiplayer realm, we have Anvil Empires. That's right, an MMO that's going to be based in the city building realm. So this is where you and thousands of other players will join forces to build empires, wage wars, and conquer in a persistent online world. But first things first, at the heart of this game is going to be building. So you're going to be laying down the foundations of mighty settlements and growing them from small hamlets into bustling towns with your friends online. Of course, warfare is going to make up a large part of the game, and there will be epic battles as well. And I think what is going to dictate these is going to be the strong economy and supply chains rather than just brute strength. And on that note, there is going to be a huge amount of focus on supply and demand. Supply camps, logistic lines, keeping your armies well fed, armed and rested. So it's not just about the typical MMO experience of action, action, action. This one seems to have quite a degree of strategy thrown in. One to take a look at and one to keep an eye on if multiplayer is your thing. Alright folks, let's dive into Norland next, a medieval kingdom sim that's all about generating epic stories. You're managing your noble family through a whirlwind of conflicts, crime, economic management, supply chains and the like. This one's intriguing. If you caught our recent feature on the channel, you might already be familiar with this one. Yes, it's another gem coming up from Hooded Horse. And I really enjoyed engaging with the demo. It has a very polished feel with a boatload of mechanics thrown in, and it really throws you in the thick of medieval life. There's a lot of economic focus, building, upgrading those buildings, creating efficient production chains, and the twist is you've also got to consider it with your environment of the world around you, migrants, tempting wages, things like this to bring people coming to your settlement. And then the last veneer, but maybe the most important, is the social shenanigans on top. It's all about the people. Tons of social dynamics at play. You'll find yourself knee-deep in intrigue, drama, maybe even a little bit of backstabbing along the way. Hugely high on this one, and I'll definitely feature it again with a review closer to the time of release. Let's talk about Bellwright next, the game that's all about building, battling, and becoming the hero your people need. The thing that's interesting with this one is not going to stick to one genre. It is a blend of city building with action-packed combat that will hopefully create a gaming experience that's truly unique. I'm always up for these hybrid style games, another one is FPS, crossword strategy games. They can be a lot of fun if they're done right. So picture this, you're not just constructing buildings, you're liberating land, assisting villagers, and recruiting others to your cause. I hope it's going to be something along the lines of SimCity meets epic fantasy adventure. Of course, there's going to be resource and town management thrown into this one, so organizing workers, training soldiers, building your town up and your rebellion up from the ground against the corrupt prince. And on that note, there is going to be a storyline with this one. So hopefully that's something typically lacking sometimes in city builders. This one will keep you on the edge of your seat from start to finish. And the graphics look pretty sweet as well. Definitely give this one a follow, guys. Now it's time to unleash your inner Norseman, LT Gamers, with Viking City Builder. This isn't going to be your run-of-the-mill game, no, it's going to be a hybrid of city building and real-time strategy, hopefully creating a unique gaming experience. A huge focus here will go on the battles, but also fortifying your settlements, battling off those annoying pesky Europeans who want to take back their territory, and then sailing down the rivers, pillaging, plundering, all the good stuff you want to see in a Viking game. It looks like they're going to try and keep historical authenticity with structures straight from Viking history textbooks and give you the ability to manage this settlement, assign tasks, and build a strong economy like a true Viking chieftain. One of the main reasons this is in the list is because it's an indie title and we love indie titles here at LT Gaming. Nothing's better than supporting one of these devs who pour their heart and soul into creating gaming experiences and seeing that succeed. So this is brilliant and one of quite a few indie titles we have on the list. All right, LT Gamers, let's talk about Infection Free Zone, the game that's all about surviving, rebuilding, and kicking some infected ass. Picture this, you're not just playing in some fantasy made-up map, you're playing in your own backyard, your neighborhood. With Infection Free Zone, you can choose any real region from the world and set up shop. And this is thanks to OpenStreetMap's real-world data, you have endless possibilities. Building your base, it's not all about sightseeing around the globe, but you rebuild and readapt the buildings surrounding you to create a self-sustaining settlement. Shelters, production facilities, farms, powerhouses, you turn your region into an infection-free zone, one area at a time. It's all about surviving and thriving, and when night falls, it's about defending your zone from the infected. It is a zombie apocalypse. One thing that makes me very excited about this game is I have early access to it. I'm playing it right now, the full version, and I've been playing all the places around the world I've lived, and it adds a whole new level of immersion to the experience. I'm gonna drop a full review hopefully next week, and I'll spill all the juicy details. So if you are intrigued by anything I said in this one, make sure to wishlist the game. Brace yourselves, LT Gamers, because we're going to dive back into the frozen wasteland now with Frostpunk 2 and face a whole new icy apocalypse. It's 30 years after the Great Storm and you're back in the Frostland, facing a brand new threat, good old human nature. That's right, in Frostpunk 2, the real enemy isn't the blizzard, it's the unsated thirst for power. It's going to be city building expanded here, where you're not just building your city on the scale as before, it's going to be leveled up entirely. Think entire districts with different purposes, industrial, scientific, and so on. There's going to be a huge amount of machinations behind the scenes, where you have to deal with a council and forge new laws for your growing metropolis. You can think benevolent ruler or succumb to the dark side. This gives you a lot of agency here. I have explored this title a lot more in a longer preview video, but the main question for me, which you can check out by the way, but the main question for me is, can it exceed the original and deliver another classic? I go into all the details in the other video, so really go check that out if you're intrigued here. But judging from the amount of wishlists, there is a huge amount of anticipation here, so I hope they can deliver. Alright LT Gamers, gather around, it's time to talk about everyone's favourite medieval city builder, Manor Lords. First off, let's address that Manor Lords recently snatched the number one top spot from Hades 2 on wishlists, and we are really pumped about this. It's showing the level of excitement is building and building to new levels. Speaking of building, it is going to be a mega hyped release here, for good reason, but also that is going to carry a huge weight of expectation. If it doesn't end up in the contenders for Game of the Year, I think this game will be considered a miss. But with its in-depth city building, tactical battles, and complex economic situations, I think it probably has a good shot. We have very organic gridless city building, giving you full freedom on placement and rotation. We have economic simulation that gives you goods fitting for the era. Luxury items, trade goods, forge arms and armor, medieval economics at its best. And then of course epic battles as you balance competing ambitions between you and your neighboring lords. Conflict is going to happen and you're going to have to lead your people into battle and protect your beloved loyal subjects. And the other thing here, the elephant in the room, it's a solo dev, which has some risks, but also prompts me to give it a lot of kudos and love here. But to alleviate some concerns, they are backed by Hooded Horse, who, as you know from the rest of this list, we're massive fans of here, and we always think they deliver high quality goods. So it's our top pick on this list, and I think for very good reason. Go wishlist it today, increase that lead it has, and let's see how the release goes later this month. In conclusion, LT gamers, we have a great lineup of upcoming city builders in 2024. Icy Wastelands on one hand, Bustling Streets of Medieval Germany on the other. Each game is going to offer a unique take on the city building genre, and I couldn't be more excited for how this is going to all play out in 2024. If you like anything that you saw here, drop down below into the links and add it to your wish lists. Of course, we love when you support us here at LT Gaming. Give us a comment if you feel I've missed any games. Give us a comment on your thoughts. Hit the like button to help on the algorithm for YouTube. And of course, subscribe for more gaming content from Luke and I here at LT Gaming. Thanks for tuning in, guys, and I'll see you on the next one. Bye-bye now.